today anyway, and you're setting spring barley, is it?
Yeah. Clean it.
Very good.
I'm planting barley there, 12.5 stone. And this is the old talk, 193 kgs an hectare. So we're sitting with that.
Very good, and in good conditions?
Yeah, too dry, drinking a lot of water.
It's just very dusty right now.
Yeah, no, it is. It's very dusty right, but they're able to roll straight behind us, like, which makes a big difference. Like, it's something you wouldn't see around Ireland much of that.
Yeah. And you're nearly finished with the say seven spring barley.
Yeah, I'm hoping not. This is it for combining today, like, and maybe a small bit for all crop over the next few days. This is it now, as far as I know. We had a busy 10 days, and I think.
Make most of the dry spell.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, we don't know ourselves after the winter, like, to come back and have to go this hard, like, for a couple of days. You'd probably be glad of a bit of rain, like.
Yeah. It has, even the winter, I suppose, to be fair, has been quite dry.
Yeah, it has, yeah. It definitely has. No, we can't complain, sure. I'd say there'll be no maize or nothing for 2 weeks, like, so we'll have a bit of a break now again. Unless now people come in. The forecast is definitely changing now again, looking at it, like.
Very good, and you're in a Massey 7726. How are you finding that?
Oh yeah, I love the tractor, to be fair. I can't fault it. Like, I've got now the 50 to 8s, and even I had a demo on John Deere 6250R one day, and I was happy sitting in this, as I needed over two of them, and I saw dead beer kind of competitors, like.
Yeah.
Very happy, like, to be honest. And like, since the Trimble Guidance system has gone into it, I'm actually very happy every day now. Like, it's really spot the reliability issues with the Massey system that came with the first day, and now since the Trimble system has gone in, like, it's fairly earned out now, like, and it's far superior too with the stuff that we can do on it.
Yeah.
So I'm fair happy, like, a lot of things, like the virtual section control is a great job, and also I have to say I love the tram lines and the screen and things like that. It's a great job now when I don't have markers anymore. It's just another way of keeping track of it a lot easier, and if I want to start saving on one side of the field, like, because with a 3 meter press, like, unfortunately all these press manufacturers are making the presses 3 meters,
yeah.
And if we set up the hill while we're trying to keep up top of the sowing, the rings of the press are driving the seed down into the ground, and it actually, when you see it coming up, like, it is a big difference, like. So when we can set, take the line from the top of the field and set up the hill, the press is always off the sowing, and it makes a big difference for the field to come up dead even, no seed struggling to come up at the start or anything like that, like. So that's my big advantage of this system inside the tractor, like.
Very good. See, when you're spraying and spreading, you'll save there as well.
Yeah, more definitely. Yeah, like, we're like, I don't know, I can't remember what your RTK is called, but like, I call it RTK, like, the accuracy is down to, to 2 inches, like, but like, we have the drill set out at like 3.05, which means like we're merely saving a quarter, like, every run of the drill, like, there's 20 quarters on the drill, which means like every 20 runs, like, we're saving a full run of the drill. So like, we were inside in a 97 acre field the other day, it was 210 runs, saving a quarter every time. That's nearly 20 runs of the drill, which means on the 80 meter tram lines, we're nearly saving a tram line and a half, like. Sure, that's spray, fertilizer, everything, like, but you don't, just for paying for a small bit more precision, you know.
Yeah.
Otherwise, like, it's go a small bit cheaper and set your drill in at 3 meters and just keep driving then and overlap away, like.
Yeah.
That's all. It's definitely all adding up in a.
Especially, I suppose, the year that's in it, the cost of inputs are fairly high, and.
Yeah, like, to be fair to the drill, like, no matter what, like, you put in whatever you want into it, like, since we've got solid air 9, like, you calibrate the drill, like, it is exactly what it's supposed to be, like. In fairness, like, no matter what, I've had guys hand me mules, they mix for organic farms with beans, peas, everything in it. Once we set the drill up, like, it does do what it says in the tin, like, and with the guidance now, like, we're not using the seed either, because the drill isn't setting every extra run, like, so this, like, when the drill says it's putting it out at 12 stone, like, you're not just putting money off the trailer, like, you can trust the drill. You can trust the guidance, like, and you're saving bags of seed every day as well.
So it doesn't belong all adding up, like?
No, definitely not, no. Definitely not, like. It's definitely, like, you might see it as much in the smaller fields, like, but in the big fields, like, you see it big style, like, by driving out that, we could be, like, in a 20-acre field, we could gain a half an acre, like, of seed not needed, like, that would just be thrown out for the sake of throwing it out because the farmer has of them, the trailer, like, we need to get rid of them, like.
Yeah.
So it's definitely way more precision style, like. I think it's working better, and the farmers are a lot happier.
Yeah,
and
I suppose you could even see it there,
in,
like you were saying, in the winter.
Yeah, oh, that's, I'm definitely, it's the happiest I've ever been with the sowing was last winter, like. And I can't really fault it enough, to be honest. It's just turning on and it works, like, great job, whereas before we were messing a lot now with it, like. I definitely don't think like a guy will drive it as good, like, as free to air, like, with his markers all day long, like, or with the cheaper ones, but when it comes to the RDK, like, style, like, down to the accuracy, like, you won't do it all day, like, no way, not all day long cruising away at the speed you're doing, like, you know, the phone might ring or something, and there's your wheel, and that wheel is there for a while, like.
And do you use the systems later in the year for section rate control and spreading and
We don't do any spraying or spreading. Well, we do spreading fertilizer, but this tractor doesn't be at it.
Oh, yeah.
So really, truthfully, like, we're using the system for sitting on the corn, winter and spring, and we're using the system on the sample maize seeder, which we've been doing before, and it's also mowing with the mowing system there, triple fast mowers. So it's kind of being used a lot in the year, but it's kind of takes it a bit easier during the summer, like, and maybe it's not in the winter, but we get a good bit of use out of it, like. You're working here all the time, they're rich in the machine, and like they're fairly well used to it now as well, like they're getting the hang of it. Rich uses all the time, like he's on the field safe from mowing, and even now, like when he goes back to a second job, he doesn't even have to nearly mow the first round of the headline because it's recorded.
Oh,
and
yeah.
He actually, so if he went into the fields now second cut, it'll actually drive the tractor and drive around the first round of the headline. Maybe watch the small bit at the corner just because your infill pattern and things like that, but in general, like I can come back to any of these fields like 12 months later, like, and it will put the tram line exactly where it was, like, there's no satellite drift, there's no nothing, it is spot on, like.
Yeah.
So they love it mowing, like, and, like, you know, it's anything really, like, and it all goes down to for the mowing, like, with the rake, everything follows it, and then the side of the tram, so, like, you see the lads drawing, like, they don't be in and out, they don't be watching it, it just makes everyone's life easy, every day, really, like.
Yeah.
Any day I see it working in I'm glad to see it working, like, great job, like.
It takes the hassle out.
It takes the hassle out of everything, yeah. Yeah, but look, the moral of the story is, I suppose, like, if you're setting the field off a curve like they used to years ago, like, sure, it really makes no difference what way you set it compared to the setting it dead straight and everything. It does look a bit better, it's not much better, but where it is better is your joint or your accuracy all day long, like, when you're putting it in, like, you know. So, like, we're happy enough, like, we're so confident we don't even have markers on the drill, like, anymore, like, you know.
Yeah.
And, like, that was a big step forward, like, in our place, like, take the guys that are sitting since the 90s with one passes, like, and whatever, like, and sure, they definitely got a heart attack when they saw a drill coming without markers, like.
Yeah.
You know, so, it's great.
Oh, that's very good. That's perfect, Jamie. Thanks, anyway, for having
me
say today.
Oh, no problem. Yeah, it's no matter, it's more than welcome.